different.
Well, that's just it. I guess you're probably trying to represent the majority of your constituency, but from what I see, they're not even representing that. Like, you read some things that get passed, and you go, no one would vote for that.
No one's
going to vote for more money for my representative.
No one's
going to fucking say, I agree with that.
We got Patrice on the line. Patrice O'Neill, everyone. What's up, Patrice?
Hi, Patrice.
Hey, good morning.
My co-star in the new upcoming film. Hi, yes. Patrice.
Well, I'm keeping that on the L there, buddy. You never know. So, I called to say that I agree with Anthony.
Thank you, sir.
Almost 100%, but the problem is the two things. One is that this is not about money, because money, they're just printing money. They're printing up, you know, $780 billion here and there. And what they're doing is it's easy to attack people that the masses don't care about or they hate, which is the rich. But it's just to keep them off focus, where this particular government right now is trying to take over industry. They take over the cars, they're taking over houses, they're taking over health insurance, man. Taking over health insurance has nothing to do with money. It has something to do with people. They trying to clear people out of here, man. You see what's happening in England and in Canada. The government decides who lives and who dies, man.
Yeah, exactly. And see that. Thank you. You're right.
But well, hold on.
You're
talking about, let me ask you something, Patrice. You're talking about them taking over the industry, and Rush Limbaugh talked about this too. Them taking over the banks. When someone like GM or some company goes, bail us out, and they go to the government with their hat out and they go, give us money, and the government gives them money. And what they do with it is they wind up bonusing, like I think AIG did this. They wind up bonusing their executives, and the public goes, we want these people shot. The government steps in and goes, we'll give you money,
let me say this, though, Norton. They bonus dictators when they take over land in other countries. They give money. See, they give money to people that help them out. They give money to dictators who kill their own people and help them sell their own land to the government.
Let me
the same thing they do to GM when these guys help them in this takeover. They go, thanks, it's a kickback, man. All in cahoots, man.
Patrice, let me throw this in though, because a lot of people got mad at them bonusing some of the executives in these companies that were bailed out. But let me put it in terms that I think we can understand as a show here at Sirius Satellite Radio. That used to be, you know, XM. What if, Opie, they bonused, the satellite industry has gone through some dire straits financially. I don't think it's any secret. What if they bonused Elo to keep him here? And Elo is a very good guy, man, very good for the job, but he was offered a better job, a higher paying job with more security.
Right.
Now, they were saying they're bonusing some of these executives because they're going to fucking leave and leave a void of management. Whether it's good or bad, I have no idea. But this void of management that they can't afford to just lose and have to find new guys. I would rather them have paid Elo more money.
Sure.
And giving him job security to keep him here.
Well, we also know that most of the management in the radio industry, they're shit.
But I mean, that though was their excuse.
Right.
I'll say excuse because
that.
I don't know if it was. They're basically saying they're going to lose some very important people.
I don't know the industry enough to know
whether it's a good or bad thing.
We could talk for the radio world.
But yeah, that would have been good.
I would love to see half of management kicked out the door in their big salaries.
Especially at the old place.
Especially at the old place.
That's not simple. That's not simple enough for what's going on. The reason it's easy. It's the Robin Hood thing. You need the masses. You need a majority of the people to support what you do, and to support taking over an industry.
Mm-hmm.
What they did is they go, we're gonna get these rich assholes, so that the people that's walking around that really don't look further into what's happening, go good. And they just look at it like robbing from the rich to help everyone. This, people are saying socialism, man, but this is close to something else. I get nervous to say it publicly, but It ain't just socialism.
But the whole planet was was in a economic toilet. And what happens is a GM really was, or all these other places were in deep financial trouble. Factories were closing, people were getting laid off. The reality is it was happening.
But is the answer a government then taking over and owning a majority share in this company?
What's the option, though?
The option is you let them fold, and then another industry comes from that vacuum.
Then people can't complain. Okay, fair enough. But then people who are auto workers who can't complain that all of a sudden 50,000 of them are out of work and have nothing.
Well, then let them talk to their union delegate and say, why am I out of a fucking job now? Well, because you demanded fucking $90 an hour to stand and work a fucking spot welding machine.
Bullshit, though. If they said to you, this is, 80%, I'm just making up a number, but how many people do you think would think the economy was better if someone told them it was? If they got on the news and said, the economy is better, most people would spend money because they was told that.
You're right. Yep. No, believe me, I know how stupid people are, and they're sheep. And you're absolutely right. And to panic on the news sells a lot better. So to make it seem like, oh, my God, we're on the brink of disaster. There's worldwide financial trouble. Things are actually starting to bottom out, as they say, turn around. And I think we're not seeing the same the news really pounding the fact home that, oh, my God, we're in dire straits. And people are kind of spending a little more money.
And Anthony, you said the unions, and look, the unions overextend sometimes.
Yeah,
but the union's argument would be, look, we have taken pay cuts. They have at times taken pay cuts, and what they say is, who is telling executives to take pay cuts? Nobody. So here, the union takes a certain hit, and then meanwhile, these scumbag executives are bonusing each other. So then the government steps in and goes, if you want more of our money, you're not going to bonus
them. Answer that one. Then the same thing. It doesn't matter if it's the executives or the workers and their union. Too much money goes out. The government doesn't step in, and the company fucking folds. And then another company comes out of it that goes, all right, we can do this cheaper and better and here, so let's fucking do it this way. Mm-hmm. And perhaps they should be given tax breaks. Instead, you're right.
Taking over industries one by one.
Yeah, but instead of letting, instead of letting the company fold and then letting the private sector business step in and fill that void with another company, employing people, starting from scratch, the government steps in and owns the company? Well, that's insanity.
The government didn't do it by force.
Anthony, the void is because, look, let's say that they let that happen,
yep,
and some other guy has a better product. But as long as they're telling everybody, all right, that you have no money, they're telling us that we have no money, all they got to do is now take over whatever the industry they want to and then go, hey, we got money. That's it. It's completely acceptable now.
You're right. It's completely acceptable now. The government has made it where people don't get surprised that they now are owning private fucking companies.
But the government's not running. The government's not running in and taking over these things. People are going to them begging for money.
Giving it to them. Companies have begged for government bailout money for years. Look at Chrysler. Years ago, when Iacocca was in charge, he went to the government. The government gave him money. He paid the government back with interest. It was a loan. This government is coming in and actually taking part ownership
Didn't they give money to, like, I think it was AIG.
Yeah.
They gave money to AIG. And what AIG did was the amount of money that those motherfuckers bonus. I mean, I understand keeping a guy like Elo.
No, you're right.
But it was disgusting. And the people were like, what are you doing?
Yeah, it was
so
amazing.
Then the government's like, okay, well, if you want more money, this is how it has to be, because you cannot be trusted to behave honorably. There's a balance here. The government is not... I don't want them running everything.
You're giving them a lot more credit as being just we were put in this position where we had to do this. It's a very calculated move based on opportunity. There was an opportunity that they saw and went like, wow, we can start scooping up these companies. And the government running a publicly traded company is crazy.
The plan for all of this is sticking it to people with money. Like, that's the front.
Right. That's the...
We're going to get you, rich people.
Right, and everyone can get behind that.
Yay! But now, when you get this public health care. Look, our health care system is an unfair system too. But what it does is it allows you to live if you have the ability to live. A government controlled health care system they equate whether you're worth keeping alive.
If there's some Indian kid that's born with another kid attached at the asshole, they don't fly to fucking Romania to get them cut in half. They always wind up coming to the United States. Heart problems. They come to the United States. A child has a brain tumor. They come to the United States. You know why? We have very good health care here if you can afford it. There are varying levels of health care. And you are guaranteed the right to health care in an emergency room. In those circumstances, if you go in, it's
absolutely,
not going to be...
man.
It's not going to be free.
Absolutely, dude.
I agree.
I used to think, my mind moved to a different point of view, man. And it's not because I give a shit about rich people's pockets. It's the government controlling everything is bugs me. This is not.
Yep.
They're printing fake money. Money means nothing. You think 5% of somebody's shitty $300,000 helps? Fuck no. It's just taking over, man. Anyway, thanks,
yeah.
Fellas.
Right on, Patrice.
Hey, thanks for calling, man.
Great phone call. It's, Patrice O'Neill, everyone.
Yeah, but it's also like this. We have this thing to look at the government like it's this this brilliant calculating organism. And at times, maybe it's sneaky and shitty. But the bottom line is certain members of society have been proven that...